In another video, we learned how to form ions and ionic compounds given their location on the periodic table. So we said that metals in group 1 and 2 and 3 like to form plus 1, plus 2, and plus 3 ions. Group 4 tends to not form ions at all, and then group 5 minus 3, group 6 minus 2, group 7 minus 1, group 8, the noble gases, don't form ions at all. Okay, and so in those columns, when we form ionic compounds, the ions tend to follow those particular charges. Now the transition metals that are in the D block of the periodic table in the middle here, and also contained within the F block of the periodic table at the bottom, they tend to form ions of varying charges. So we'll have to talk more about them in a moment, okay? But we can form ions, say, if we wanted to form an ionic compound between sodium and chloride. Sodium's dot structure looks like this, fluoride's looks like this. Okay, 7 valence for fluorine, 1 valence for oxygen. When forming an ionic compound, we transfer one electron to fluorine, eliminating the extra electron from sodium's valence shell, forming an octet with the same electron configuration as neon, and then fluorine gets a minus one charge, having satisfied its octet. So overall, we would just write it NaF without the charges. Okay, so we've learned how to do that already. Now let's learn how to properly name an ionic compound given its molecular formula. Okay, so nomenclature, pointing out from the periodic table that we are indeed using a metal and a non-metal when binary ionic compounds are formed. So the metal is going to form the cation and the non-metal is going to form the anion. So with nomenclature of ionic compounds, we have a few simple rules that we can learn to get the name correct every time. So we're going to name the main group metal directly from the periodic table. So Mg, we've learned magnesium. Name it directly from the table, and the non-metal is going to get an IDE suffix. So magnesium chloride. No prefixes on either element name are necessary, because we get the numbers from crossing the charges to balance and charge balance. Okay, so we've learned how to do that already. No prefixes needed. Only a few special rules for naming ionic compounds. And like we said, if that metal is a transition metal, we're going to have to use Roman numerals to indicate the charge, because it's not easily predicted without already knowing what the charge is on the metal. So we have to say then, iron 3-bromide. Okay, this doesn't apply to the non-metals at all, just the transition metal cations. Okay, so we'd have to use Roman numeral, because backtracking, we know that that's a 3+, and then bromine's always 1-, because it's in column 7 of the periodic table. If the cation or anion is a polyatomic ion, we're going to have to just learn and memorize the names of these ions from a table or a list that's given to you in your instructions or your study guide. Okay, and so you've memorized these names already, and so you know that ammonium is NH4+. There's a polyatomic cation, and a polyatomic anion like nitrate we've already memorized as well. So the final name is just the two together, ammonium nitrate. We don't require that there be two polyatomic ions together. They could be with, say, a regular metal. Okay, so just sodium nitrate in this case. Okay, so the other rules still apply. If it's not a polyatomic ion, we name it by the rules we've already mentioned. So predicting oxyanion names, we may not memorize all of the polyatomic ions, but we do need to memorize the eights. Okay, the nitrate, sulfate, or excuse me, nitrate, chlorate, and then carbonate is 2-, sulfate is 2-, and then phosphate is 3-. So nitrate, chlorate, what if we had bromate? Well, same column, same generic formula, iodate. Okay, so not too bad, but nitrate, chlorate, carbonate, sulfate, phosphate. Okay, if you're given another 8 to memorize, learn it, because then you know the others. If we have one more, take chlorine for example, or chlorate for example, one more oxygen than chlorate, we are now at perchlorate. We know chlorate. What if we go one less? ClO2-. Now we are at chlorite. And then if we are ClO and we are two less, and instead of one less, two less, we are now at hypochlorite. Okay, so we have perchlorate, chlorate, chlorite, and hypochlorite, and the naming systematic naming method is the same for all the eights. Okay, so we don't have to memorize them all. We can predict them using that trend.